According to the Allied Health Professionals Council, there are only 73 accredited medical schools in Uganda. The body warns that medical students who attend illegal medical schools risk losing their degrees, diplomas or certificates.
The institution is without the mandate of Ministry of Education, without the mandate of the Allied Professionals Council, is illegal. And we want to strongly caution and discourage all those ones, and even to call on the public that if there is any institution, you know, every member of the community these days has a right to go and demand for the authenticity, for the license in any of those institutions. Among the Allied Professionals Council, like I said, we recognize only 73, and they are on our website, which is www.ahpc.ug.
Some of you, we know for us who are from the village, including me, sometimes for us in the villages, we may eat beef or what we call meat twice a year. We don't care because that's our life. But when you come here to demand the principle, we want beef on a daily basis. We want matoke every day. When you go to your homes, even eat matoke like once a year. So when you come here, you want to demand soda, demand a lot of things you don't have your family. There's no permanent situation. Just two and a half years, you get your paper, you can't get jobs.
In most cases, they call me as a loans officer. But you know, we need to build the economy together. And a healthy community is the community that can grow wealth.
Elsewhere, preparations for the World Tourism Day celebrations on the 27th of September are in high gear, with the main event expected to take place in Hoima District. The launch took place today at Sheraton Hotel Tourism Information Center.
All our agencies will surpass the pre-COVID numbers. We work surpassed by over 100,000 pre-COVID. If you look at their numbers over 2019, from around 380,000 to around 480,000, an additional 100,000 after COVID. And most these numbers are attributed to the Ugandans traveling. As just telling you about the Uganda Museum, pre-COVID around 2019, before the lockdown, had around 55,000 visitors. Right now, after COVID, it has around 67,000 visitors. It has also surpassed the pre-COVID numbers. So is WEC that closed at around 380,000 people visiting the parks. And all these numbers are attributed to the Ugandans traveling. And I think this is a positive for us to supplement the foreigners that are coming to the country.
And having an international event celebrated in my city gives us that mileage. At the same time, we are launching the Hoima City Carnival, which is going to be a yearly event going forward. So we are launching it as a climax of the World Tourism Day. So we are looking at having these two events and also building the Hoima City Carnival to make sure people get to know about it worldwide. And next year, besides us not hosting the World Tourism Day, we'll be able to have our carnival running all the time.
I've always told people Uganda is the most beautiful country in the world. Uganda to be part of this great nature, and I am a big witness. Being a prisoner in another person's country made me fall in love, and I can witness that Uganda is the most beautiful country in the world.
In more news, Muslim leaders in Busoga have banned the issuance of marriage certificates to the various leaders in the region. They resolved that the marriage certificates will henceforth be got only from the regional headquarters.
Supreme Council headquarters should stop selling marriage certificates.
These people at times mislead, and the way when these funds are collected, they are not transparent, they are not direct to where they should stop, where they should go.
In Kamwenje District, an eye health medical camp benefited a number of residents.
People fail to identify it or identify those conditions when it is still early. Then by the time people come to know, they find when they are in advanced level.
You can see here at Rukunyi Hospital, we have a health officer that is a specialist on eyes, but we don't have some of the equipments. You have seen that they have computerized eye surgeries. So for us here, we don't have it. You have seen they are going to be giving glasses with lenses at a cost of 15,000. But when we don't have them here. When you go to a health facility that is not for government or that is private, you pay 700 and plus.
They have brought these services nearer to the people. As you can see, all this population is from around Kamwenge district and Chibale County that have come for this such a service.
Report by Jaliat Namuwaya, Godfrey Sempija, Ivan Wachibi and Antonia Twine for the news.